Good morning. Welcome to e-learning. I am P. Sakthivel, Assistant Professor, Department of EEE, Tandai Periyar Government Institute of Technology, Vellore. Today's topic, effect of source inductance on the performance of converter. Assumptions for single phase and three phase full converters, in order to derive the average output voltage, we made an assumption that the current transfers from the outgoing SCR to incoming SAR instantaneously. There is no time delay for the changeover of or for transition of current from outgoing SCR to incoming SCR. This is possible only if the voltage source has no internal impedance, but practical source always possesses the internal impedance. First of all, we consider the source impedance as resistive. That is, let we consider I0 be the constant DC load current, RS be the source resistance per phase. Then there is an voltage drop across the source resistance RS. This voltage drop for single phase full converter is I0 into RS. So the average output voltage is reduced by an amount equal to I0 RS. For three phase full converter, the average output voltage reduced by an amount equal to 2 I0 RS, that is double the drop of the single phase full converter. Practically, source resistance is low and duration of commutation is also very, very small. So the current transfer takes place immediately after the incoming SCRs are fired. Now we consider the source impedance as inductance, because the source means here we are considering the alternators, that is synchronous generators. The synchronous generators are made up of windings. This winding consists of large inductors. So the output current is constant. The source inductance causes the outgoing and incoming SCRs conduct together. During the commutation period, when both incoming and outgoing SCRs are conducting together, the output voltage is equal to the average value of the conducting phase voltage. For single phase full converter, the output voltage during this overlap. Overlap means the period which the outgoing SCR and incoming SCR conduct together is known as overlap period. So during this overlap period, output voltage for single phase full converter is given by average value of the conducting phase voltage. Average value of the conducting phase voltage. Now V0 equal to 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to 2 pi Vm sin t omega t equal to 0. Because if you integrate this sin omega t over the period of limit 0 to 2 pi, then we get an average value of 0. For three phase full converter, the load voltage during the period of overlap is equal to average value of the conducting phases A and B. That is V0 equal to VA plus VB by 2. Overlap angle mu. The commutation period in seconds when outgoing and incoming SCRs are conducting together is known as overlap period. Next, the angular period during which both incoming and outgoing SCRs are conducting is known as commutation angle or overlap angle mu in degrees or radians. Effect of the source inductance. It reduces the average output voltage. This is the major effect of the source inductance on the performance of the converters. It reduces the average output voltage. Second one, it distorts the output voltage and current waveforms. Both output voltage and current waveforms are distorted due to the source inductance. And also, it modifies the performance parameters of the converters. It is a circuit diagram of single phase full converter with source inductance LS. See here, LS is the source inductance. Here, this is the source Vs and the terminals are 1 and 2. Here we have our load. It is the waveform which shows the input waveform, gate pulse, output voltage waveform and output current during the overlap period by considering the source inductance. Now we consider the effect of the source inductance on the single phase full converter. The commutation overlap is more predominant in full converters than in semi-converters. LS is the source inductance of single phase full converter, and we assumed the load current is constant because of the large value of the source inductance. Now we consider the first terminal of the source is positive. So here we consider positive. 1 is positive with respect to 2. That is, when terminal 1 of the source voltage Vs is positive, current I1, see this, current I1 flows through this LS T1, then it flows through the load and it flows through T2. So this is shown as here, it is an equivalent circuit. In this equivalent circuit, it is shown as Vs, LS, T1, T2 and load. This is the case when terminal 1 is positive. Next, we consider terminal 2 as positive. Now, this terminal 2 becomes positive, 1 becomes negative. When terminal 2 of source voltage Vs is positive, load current I2 flows through LS. Now, it flows through LS. Then, see here, T3. Then, load and T4. It is shown as V2, LS, T3, T4 and load. Now, you see about the working of this full converter by considering the source inductance. T1, T2 are triggered at a firing angle alpha. This is firing angle alpha. At firing angle alpha, this T1 and T2 are triggered. Before triggering of this T1 and T2, already T3 and T4 are in conducts. So this conducting thyristor now ready to commutate. But because of the presence of source inductance LS, the current through outgoing devices, that is T3, T4, decreases gradually to zero from its final value of I0 or I2. See here, before the application of the firing pulse, the conducting thyristors are T3 and T4 and its current is I2. This is the steady value of the current. It does not instantaneously transfer the current to the incoming SCR T1 and T2. Instead of that, this outgoing SCR's current I2 is gradually decreases to zero. Whereas in incoming thyristors T1, T2, the current builds up gradually from zero to full value of load current I0, that is equal to I1. This blue line is the current represents for the incoming SCRs, that is T1 and T2. After the triggering of thyristors T1 and T2 at an angle of alpha, the incoming current I1 gradually increases from 0 to its final value. During the commutation or overlap angle mu, this is commutation or overlap angle mu, where the transition occurs from the outgoing SCR to incoming SCRs. All the four thyristors T1, T2, T3, T4 together conducts. See here, in this period of commutation angle mu, all the four thyristors T1, T2, T3, T4 are conducts, because T3, T4 current gets reduces, T1, T2 current gets increases. So during this overlap angle, all the four thyristors are conducting together. Output voltage during overlap. During the overlap angle mu, the output voltage will be zero. It is shown here. After the application of the current pulse, that is gate pulse at IG1 and IG2 after alpha, this is the period of overlap angle. During the overlap angle, the output voltage is zero. Average output voltage. Average output voltage without source inductance V0 is given by 2 Vm by pi cos alpha. It is the average output voltage of the full converter without considering the source inductance. Now we consider the source inductance. Average output voltage with source inductance is given by V0x equal to 2 Vm by pi cos alpha minus omega Ls by pi into I0. So now the average output voltage is reduced by the factor of omega Ls I0 by pi from the full converter output voltage. This is the DC equivalent circuit of the full converter by considering and source inductance. DC equivalent circuit of single phase full converter. So this is an internal voltage 2 Vm by pi cos alpha here, and diode is connected in series with the source, and this is the source inductance effective resistance. Effective resistance of the source inductance is represented by omega Ls by pi, and I0 is the load current. This diode D indicates that load current is unidirectional, and effect of the source inductance Ls is Ls provides an equivalent resistance of magnitude omega Ls by pi. See here, omega Ls by pi is the series resistance provided by the source inductance to the internal voltage 2 Vm by pi cos alpha. From DC equivalent circuit, the voltage drop due to Ls, that is source inductance, is proportional to I0 and Ls. This voltage drop is directly proportional to two factors. One is this Ls and another one is I0. As load current or source inductance increases, the commutation interval or overlap angle mu increases. As a consequence, the average output voltage will get decreases. This diagram shows the average output voltage V0 against to the I0 or mu, where I0 is the load current, mu is the overlap angle. See here, where I0 or mu0 equal to 0, the output voltage V0 is given by 2 Vm by pi cos alpha. But here, gradually if we increase the overlap angle or I0, when it reaches this mu equal to pi, the average output voltage V0 becomes 0. Observations. In single phase full converter, as long as mu less than pi, the output voltage is given by 2 Vm by pi cos alpha minus omega Ls by pi into I0. But when this mu equal to pi, the load will be permanently short circuited by SCR. So the output voltage will be 0, because during the overlap angle, all the SCRs will be conducting. See here, when this mu naught reaches pi, here when mu naught reaches pi, then average output voltage will become 0, because all the 4 thyristors are conducting together. Thank you.